Hi friends, welcome to my channel Plants and Birds. Friends, in last video of floriculture, we have discussed about the problems in vegetable production. In this video, we are going to discuss how these problems can be solved by the new topic of floriculture, that is classification of vegetable crops. By knowing this, we can cultivate the vegetables by solving this all problems. Okay. Firstly, okay, based on we learn in this classification part one class based on method of culture classification, based on method of culture classification, based on season of growing classification, based on area of seed production classification, based on hardness classification, based on soil pH or reaction classification, based on salt tolerance. Firstly, classification based on method of culture, that is which is the best method for the best for the vegetable crops, because each group of vegetables have some different cultural operations, and each group of vegetables require different climatic conditions, and each group of vegetables require different soil pHs. All the vegetables are grouped in 16 groups, which will be decides this group of vegetables needs this some different. Okay, so that farmer can know this group of vegetables need this type of soil, this type of climate, so that we can cultivate in this season. Okay, so for the vegetable growers, this is the best for vegetable growers. See, group one, potato. Potato requires some different cultural operations and soil pH and soil structure all must be different, and climate also, it will mostly suitable for temperate climate. Okay. And next, group 2, solanaceous fruits, that is tomato, brinjal, chili, sweet pepper, that is capsicum. Okay, sweet pepper means capsicum. Okay, which need some different cultural operations. Next, cucurbit, group 3, cucurbits. Cucurbits means pumpkin, muskmelon, watermelon, cucumber, bottle gourd, ash gourd, ridge gourd, snake gourd, sponge gourd, bitter gourd, summer squash, winter squash, this all come under the cucurbits. This is very important to be known. Okay, this requires very different. Okay, because their cultivation done in the beds. Okay, river beds. Okay, which required staking operations like. Okay, next staking. Okay, next group 5. That is. Group 4, root crops. In group 4, root crops. Root crops means radish, carrot, beet, turnip. Okay, all will come under the root crops, which require different operations. Okay, next group 6. Next, bulb crops. In bulb crops like onion, garlic, leek. Okay, this all come under the bulb crops. Okay, see. For each group, the cultural operations and management is different. Okay, so this classification is very useful for vegetable growers. Okay, next, group 7, salad crops. See, salad crops like lettuce, celery. Okay, all come under the salad crops. Next, group 8. Group 8 means green and pot herbs. Here, green and pot herbs means amaranth, that is leafy vegetables, mainly amaranth, palak, spinach, fenugreek, coriander, Indian spinach, French spinach, all come under this green and leafy vegetables, green and pot herbs. Okay, this requires very different. Okay, they are grown in upper layer only. Okay, the roots cannot be penetrated inside. Okay, so that the fertilizer dose is very less. Okay, so like that. Okay, we will come to know what type of group of vegetables one need what type of cultural operations by knowing this classification. Next is group 9, that is peas and beans including gourd. Here I mentioned peas and beans including gourd means many of the people don't know that gourd, that is cluster bean, belong to this peas and bean family, so they cultivate easily in outside, and the face many losses. Okay, it is very sensitive. Okay, these peas and beans are very sensitive to the climatic and pests and diseases. So that mainly they are cultivated in protected cultivation, like French bean, hyacinth bean, asparagus, cluster bean, winged bean, lima bean. All are cultivated inside the polyhouses. Next, group 10, tuber crops. Tuber crops means like yam, elephant foot yam, okay, Chinese potato, tuber crop. Okay, tuber crop other than potato. Here no potato, because first group we decided that potato will have different operations. Other tuber crops like yam, elephant foot yam, cassava, and Chinese potato, okay, will have different than potato. Other than potato cultural crops. Next, group 11, sweet potato. See, this is important. Sweet potato will have different cultural operations. Okay, not included in the root crops like carrot, radish. We can't add that in that group. Sweet potato will have different cultural operations. Next, texture all can be different. Okay, fertilizers, solar must be different. Next, group 12, okra. This is very important. The only vegetable of Malvaceae which is edible is okra. Okay, so that it is placed in a different group. Okay, it is very easy to grow and cultural operations is less. Okay, so that it is grouped under group 12. Next, group 13, pointed gourd. Okay, next, group 14, chow-chow or chayote, it is called chow-chow. Okay, group 15, tropical perennial crops like drumstick, curry leaf, all come under this group. Okay, they require very less cultural operations and maintenance is very easy. Okay, so that group 15, group 16, temperate perennial vegetable crops like asparagus. Okay, is come under this group. Okay, this is about the first base classification that is based on method of culture, how they are cultured. Next, based on season of growing. See, this is important here. Based on season of growing, in what season what crops must be grown, we must have some knowledge so that we can grow that vegetable in that season without getting any losses. In that first, okay, this is important classification for growers, as I told you. If you grow onion in kharif season, you will face the rotting of the bulbs, then loss can be made. So that for growers point of view, everyone know is important. This season of growing is very important. Classification based on season of growing. Firstly, rabi season vegetables, that is winter season. What the vegetables that must started in sown in winter and grown throughout the winter and summer are potato, carrot, garlic, radish, all coli crops, onion, garden pea, beetroot. These all, mainly all root vegetables and tuber vegetables are grown in this winter because no rains are there, there is no high humidity, so that disease incidence is low in this season and which is suitable for their growth and development. Next, kharif season vegetables. Okay, this means summer and rainy season, which are cultivated in summer and rainy season. That is tomato, brinjal, chili, okra, cucumber, bitter gourd, ridge gourd, bottle gourd. Bitter gourd means all you know, bitter gourd, ridge gourd, bottle gourd, snake gourd, cluster beans, beans, sweet potato, watermelon, muskmelon, summer squash. Okay, this is about the kharif season vegetables, which must be sown and grown under this kharif season, that is summer and rainy season. Tomato, brinjal, chili, okra, cucumber, bitter gourd, ridge gourd, bottle gourd, snake gourd, cluster beans, okay, sweet potato, watermelon, muskmelon, summer squash. Again, this is all grown in this. Only tuber vegetable which is grown in kharif season is sweet potato. Root crop, okay, that is sweet potato, must be remembered here. Okay, if any vegetable name is not, please refer once Google. Okay, Google images. Next, based on area of seed production, that is temperate, subtemperate, tropical. This is important. This is somehow important because
what if you bring that cabbage seeds and sown in tropical, they will not grow. Okay, so that you must need this classification based on area of seed production. Temperate, in temperate means which need cooled, very cooled, okay, like Himachal Pradesh, like that. Okay, in that place has cabbage, okay, cooled environment present there. Okay, that place is cabbage, potato, broccoli, carrot, garden beet are grown. Subtemperate, okay, late cauliflower, spinach, okay. Subtemperate varieties of radish, carrot can be grown in subtemperate. Tropical, okay, here see some important thing, tropical, okay, main vegetables like tomato, brinjal, okra, chili, sweet pepper, all cucurbits, ginger, okay, turmeric, colocasia, sweet potato, cardamom are grown in tropical. One must be known is sweet potato is a tropical vegetable, keep in your mind. Okay, tomato, brinjal, okra, chili, sweet pepper, all cucurbits, ginger, turmeric, colocasia, sweet potato, cardamom. Okay, are the tropical, that means which grow in our this Karnataka, okay, all this Andhra Pradesh, all these regions. Next, based on hardiness, okay, ability which is important, because according to the field and according to the soil culturing, according to the soil we can cultivate, and according to the climate, okay, so this is useful to cultivate according to the climate. Okay, if you okay, see, based on hardiness, ability to withstand frost and low temperature. If hardy vegetables means they can withstand frost and okay, low temperature. Semi hardy means they withstand somehow okay, low temperature and somehow frost. Tender means they cannot withstand frost and low temperature. This is the okay, you will learn about that. Hardy means in hardy vegetables we will grow cabbage, spinach, radish, onion, garlic, crucifers, asparagus are come under the hardy vegetables. Semi hardy means the hardy vegetables means which can tolerate the frost and low temperature. Semi hardy, carrot, palak, potato, cauliflower, lettuce can tolerate only somewhat frost and low temperature. Okay, cauliflower come under the semi-hardy, cabbage come under the hardy. You must keep in your mind. Tender means which cannot tolerate frost and low temperature. That is tomato, brinjal, chili, capsicum, okra, cluster beans, amaranth, cucurbits, colocasia, yam, sweet potato, amaryllis. All majorly all tropical vegetables. All tropical vegetables. Okay, hardy means mainly all temperate vegetables. Okay, semi-hardy means all semi. Okay, subtemperate vegetables. Next is based on soil pH or reaction. This is a very 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 important classification according to me, because some farmers will have alkaline soil, some farmers will have okay, acidic soils, because so that in that acidic soils they think there is no crops to grow, so that if they know this, they can grow some of the vegetables. Okay, this based on soil pH means or reaction means the pH below 6.5, below 6.5, that is acidic pH. What are the vegetables we are going to see? We will see about what introduction about the soil pH below 6.5. When pH is below 6.5, like nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium, sulfur are not available to plants. See, in acidic pH mainly macronutrients, that is both primary and secondary nutrients, are not available to the plants. Then how the plant will grow? So at low pH, what happened? You will see now. At low pH, that is below 6.5, iron and aluminium become active and combines with phosphorus, magnesium, calcium and makes unable to plants. This is important. Iron and aluminium combined with phosphorus, magnesium, calcium, not with nitrogen, potassium, okay, sulfur. These three not will be ignored. Okay, magnesium, calcium, phosphorus will combine. Iron and aluminium combined with phosphorus, magnesium, calcium, and these three will main elements that can be unavailable to plants. Okay, so that to make it neutral, what is added means gypsum salt is added to the soils, so that their pH can be reduced. Okay, next, you can see slight some what are the vegetables come under the can be tolerate this acidity. Slightly tolerate some vegetables will tolerate 6.6 to 6 up to 6 pH. If for pH is 6 also some vegetable can grow. They are cabbage, cauliflower, okra. See important is okra, onion, spinach are very important for tropical. Okay. Tropical climate. Next, moderately tolerant. That means they can tolerate up to 5.5 pH. Okay. That is somehow acidic. Okay, medium moderately acidic. Or brinjal, important. Tomato, chili, okay, capsicum. See all solanaceous vegetables and cucumber, pumpkin, and radish, garden pea, beans, carrot can all tolerate okay, moderate pH of 5 up to 5.5. Okay, very tolerant, they can tolerate up to 5. Okay, if the pH of 5 also they can be grown. They are watermelon, very very important. See for tropical region watermelon is very high. Okay, you have more scope. Okay, watermelon, potato, sweet potato, fennel, celery. Okay, we can grow watermelon for give the well with live without with live. That is why we want to live that acidic 5 if pH is 5. If you go that watermelon in summer season, there will be production will be there, very nice production will be there. Okay, watermelon can grow very well in that pH. Okay, they can tolerate that. Okay, so that some production will be there and so that we can get some income. Okay, next, based on soil tolerance, that is nothing but pH less than 6. Okay, above less than not above 7 you take that, so or 6.8. Okay, based on soil tolerance, when pH is above 7, iron, manganese, boron, and zinc become unavailable. See, if that is alkaline soils are better than acidic soils because in alkaline soils only micronutrients like iron, manganese, boron, zinc are available. But in acidic soils, macronutrients, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, okay, calcium, magnesium, sulfur are become unavailable. They are macronutrients. They become unavailable in that acidic soil. But here see, only micronutrients. We can spray okay, this micronutrients. Okay. You will see that how they are tolerant, less tolerant. Okay, how okay, they will this also make under three groups: less tolerant, moderately tolerant, tolerant. Okay, less tolerant, brinjal, sweet potato, sweet pepper, snake guard, radish, potato, sweet potato, celery all come under the less tolerant. Okay, this cannot they can tolerate up to 7.5. Okay, they will tolerate up to 6.8 to 7.5. Okay, and moderately tolerant. Okay, 6.5 to 6.8 to up to 7.8 or 7.9. They can be tolerant, moderately tolerant. Tomato, chili, bottle gourd, onion, cucumber, watermelon, muskmelon, pumpkin, amaranthus, cabbage, cauliflower can be tolerant moderately. Okay. And next, tolerant. Okay, this can tolerant up 6.8 to 8.5 or okay, 8.5 lastly. Okay, they are bitter gourd. See, this is very very important vegetable which has more scope. Okay, bitter gourd, palak, these two vegetables are very very scope. Beetroot, ash gourd also grown. Okay, this is about the classification of vegetables in first part, friends. In next part we will discuss other classification for more knowledge. Thank you, friends.